We begin tonight with news from the crime beat as detectives here in the Capitol are investigating the circumstances of the country's latest homicide. A police-involved shooting in Pinewood Gardens after responding to a disturbance which quickly turned deadly. Antoine Smith leads us off tonight from Pinewood Gardens.
Tempers flaring at the country's latest police-involved shooting in Pinewood Gardens. A blue, single-story family home on Cascarilla Street, now a crime scene as an early Monday morning domestic dispute turned deadly for one. On the scene, an elderly woman escorted by police could be seen waving and heard whispering, "Thank you, Jesus." However, police say the situation unfolded much like this hours earlier, when an adult male entered his mother's home as she engaged in her early morning prayer. Initial reports from police revealing that the man then began acting belligerent as his mother continued to pray, prompting the homeowner to call police. Commissioner of Police Paul Rowe says what happened next resulted in the injury of one of their own.
On arrival at the residence, she took the officers inside, and as she entered the room where her son was, he produced a firearm and began discharging shots at her and the officers. The officer who was leading grabbed the mother and protected her and pulled her out of the room when he was struck by a bullet to the back.
Officials say the male assailant then barricaded himself behind the doors of her room as attempts to negotiate with the suspect reportedly proved unsuccessful. The end result, evidence on the crime scene, shattered glass and bullet-riddled windows.
Officers then breached the door to the room where he was, where he again opened fire on the officers, and this time the officers shot him, fatally wounding him. A second officer, was injured in the process, received injuries to his leg.
The police commissioner confirming the injured officers are in hospital receiving treatment.
And I just want to commend the bravery of these officers and their action this morning in preserving the life of the woman who called the police, but regret that we had to, in the process, take a life in the process and persons trying to take the life of my officers here this morning.
Well, the doors of that crime scene have now been boarded as investigations are expected to continue throughout the week, revealing more details into exactly what took place on this fatal Monday morning. Antoine Smith for ZNS Network News.